Hi everyone, this is Nick, and some of our most popular videos here have been about how to use PowerPoint's Morph transition to create really beautiful, almost cinematic animations in PowerPoint without using any animation at all. A lot of you are probably familiar with that animation tab. Using Morph, you don't have to use that animation tab. You can just use the PowerPoint's built-in Morph transition. And Morph comes with Microsoft 365 subscriptions. It's slowly being rolled out to other licenses, I think, too, and even in PowerPoint for the web. So almost everybody now, I think, should have access to PowerPoint Morph unless you have a much older version or a perpetual license to Microsoft products. But I wanted to show you just some of the basics in this video. So this is kind of a PowerPoint 101, and I wanted to show you three things that I use Morph for in kind of my own work. And these are just sort of the basic building blocks. And once you learn these, you can create really cool slide transitions and slide animations using Morph. So the first thing that you can do is you can use Morph to resize objects on your slide. You might have something really small and you want to zoom in to something really big, kind of like this. So using Morph for size, the circle is small and now it becomes large. You can also use Morph to change position of objects and text on your slide. So I have a large circle here. I want to move it over to the right of the slide, or maybe I want to move it to the left of the slide, or maybe I want to move it, zoom it way off the slide itself. And you can do that very easily using the Morph transition. The other thing you can do is change shapes using Morph. So I have a circle. Maybe I want to morph that into a star. Pretty cool animation, and it's so smooth and seamless. Or maybe it's back to a rectangle, or maybe it's this sort of flag shape that they have. All of these are just regular shapes that you insert in PowerPoint, and then back to the circle. So in this video, I'm gonna show you how to do this 101 style in Morph. So let's escape out of the slide. And what I'm gonna do over here is I'm actually just going to create a new slide here from my first slide. So let's just insert a nice and new blank slide right here. I'm gonna go ahead, let's first do that size. So what you need to do is insert a shape, could be any shape. Let's just do the circle right here. I'm just gonna put that wherever you want it on the slide. Now, in order to enable Morph, everything that you have on the slide has to be duplicated. So what you kind of wanna do when you morph is start with the end in mind, and then you duplicate from there. So right here, I know I'm just gonna do the resize of the circle. So all I need on my slide is a circle. I'm gonna push Control D, and that duplicates this slide over here in the slide sorter view right there. And then in the second slide here that I duplicated, I'm going to apply the Morph transition. You just go up to the Transitions tab on the ribbon and click on Morph. Okay, perfect. Now, I didn't resize anything, so nothing's really gonna happen, but on the second slide that has the Morph transition, I'm gonna resize the circle, and I'm just gonna do it really big like that. We could keep it on or off the slide. Let's just keep it on the slide here. And now let's go ahead. You can, on the Morph slide, you can then actually just preview the Morph right here in preview mode. Go up to that Transitions tab and click on Preview and see what it looks like. A really cool Morph transition. All right, so now I'm gonna go here, and what we're gonna do now is I'm gonna duplicate this slide. And then what I'm going to do is you can keep on using this kind of as a Morph sort of chain of transitions. If I just wanted to move this circle, I could move it over here for my position. And let's say we want to resize it and make it even smaller. And let's just go ahead and put it down here in the corner. Now what Morph is going to do, since this slide was duplicated and the Morph transition is already applied, it's going to take this really big circle right here. When I advance to the next slide, it's going to take the quickest path it has to that small circle in the corner. So it's going to resize and the position is going to change. Let's go ahead and preview this slide right here in Morph, the preview right there. Awesome. Let's start from the very beginning. Let's go to this first slide here. I'm going to play this in slideshow mode, and I'm just going to click the right arrow to advance to the next slide. It's going to change the size of the Morph right here, and it's going to now, when I click to the next slide, it's going to change the position. So cool. And there are so many use cases where you might be able to use Morph in your PowerPoint presentations or in your presenting. The other thing you can do is morph the shapes, one shape into another shape. And you have to do that in a little bit different of a way here. So I'm going to go ahead and insert a brand new slide, a blank slide. And we're going to go ahead and insert a shape. We'll do that circle, that same circle again. Put that in the middle of my slide here. And now let's go ahead, and what we're gonna do is we're gonna first name this shape on the selection pane. So mine is already open. I'm gonna close it so you see how I open it. Go to the Home tab, and over here under the editing menu, click on the selection pane, the select drop-down menu, and then the selection pane. Now, this selection pane tells you all of the different objects or text boxes that live on your slide. And right now, I just have one object on the slide. It's the oval. And you can see over here, it's called oval number one. What I want to do is change the name of this so that it is going to be consistent on the next slides that I add. So I'm going to first start by putting two exclamation marks onto that name. And that's this Bang Bang Morph feature that makes sure that basically tells PowerPoint that you want this shape to be the same name as the next shape, and those two things you want to morph one into the other. So I'm just going to call this Bang Bang Morph Shape and push enter. Now, if I go ahead and duplicate this slide, you can see if I click on the oval, it's still named Bang Bang Morph Shape. And if I change the shape, go up to the Shape Format menu, Edit Shape, and we'll change this circle into a star. Perfect. You can see in the selection pane that it's still named Bang Bang Morph Shape. It didn't change to star or anything like that. So now on the second slide, we're going to go ahead back to the transitions menu, click on the morph, and so that you're applying that transition, you can see it gives you a preview of what that's going to look like. Again, you can click on the preview to see what that looks like. Let's go ahead and just duplicate this slide. Let's change this into maybe a triangle shape format, edit shape, go down to the triangle menu right here, and let's go ahead and preview this slide on the transitions tab. And it goes from that star to that rectangle. So let's go ahead back to the circle, and we're going to ahead put it in slideshow mode and push the enter, the over key, and it's going to morph into those shapes because we told PowerPoint that we wanted these shapes to be consistent and we wanted them to morph into each other with that bang bang feature, those two exclamation marks at the end. So this was a really quick sort of primer video on morph, using morph, very basic ways to use morph. But once you get these techniques, you can use them to create much more complicated animations in PowerPoint. So I hope you like this video. If you do, please give it a thumbs up and make sure to subscribe to my channel, hit the bell next to it every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Word, or Excel. You'll get notified every time that video drops. I appreciate all those likes and subscribes. I hope you had a great time watching it. I had a wonderful time making this for you, and I'll see you next time.